In the shadows of the ancient pyramids of Giza, archaeologists continue to unearth the pharaonic secrets of 2,500 years ago. This is the final resting place of a priestess named Etbet. It's the latest tomb in this region to bring Egyptologists flocking. Almost two millennia after the death of the last pharaoh, the Egyptian authorities announce more or less weekly a new discovery. This vast statue of Ramesses II was found in a residential area last year, and some experts are convinced it's just the start.
Every king had to build here, make statues, temples, obelisks, everything.
Crucial to this latest phase of discovery is archaeologists' decision to embrace technology. At the Cheops Pyramid last autumn, researchers armed with powerful scanners discovered a hidden cavity large enough to fit a plane. The plan now is to drill a 3-centimeter hole through the wall and send in a robot to find out what's inside. And it's not just the pyramids benefiting from the latest scanning innovations. Tanis in the Nile Delta is home to an entire city, buried just meters under the sand.
This is the location of one of the largest neighborhoods of the ancient city of Tanis. There are millions of these fragments here because the site's enormous. It's more than 200 hectares.
For years, the prospect of mapping the area was unthinkable. But now this machine, a magnetometer, allows archaeologists to effectively see what's under the earth. No digging required.
We can see the plan of the houses which are here, the remains of settlements.
The data collected is analyzed by a computer, eventually providing an accurate map of a buried world. At present, Tanis attracts only 1,000 tourists each year. Egyptian authorities are hoping that, as this latest technology bears ever more fruit, that number will grow.